On June 24th, the Supreme Court voted to overturn Roe v. Wade and created a real-life horror story for women in America. This decision has stripped the rights to a legal and safe abortion from millions of women in this country. It does not, however, stop abortions from happening. Countries that restrict abortions have a higher rate of abortion than countries that don't.
That is Gary Chambers, friend of the show, who's running for Senate in Louisiana, responding to the destruction of Roe v. Wade. And we're gonna show you more of the ad. Bear in mind, you might have been able to guess from the beginning, his ads are intense, understandably so. So bear that in mind as we continue.
Women in poverty are less likely to be able to afford safe methods of abortion and also risk being blackmailed to receive services and maintain confidentiality. Cases of severe hemorrhaging, poisoning, infection, or damage to internal organs are all life-threatening results that hospitals will now be faced with. I am an ordained minister, and regardless of what we all believe in, we choose those beliefs for ourselves. For scripture says in Corinthians, "For why is my liberty being judged by another man's conscience?" The government, comprised of mostly white men, has no place to decide for women what is right for them. The ability for any woman in America to make choices concerning her own health is a natural, basic democratic right of every woman. Abortions won't end, but this democracy will if the government refuses to stay out of people's personal choices. Make no mistake about it, women will die, and there's nothing pro-life about that. I'm Gary Chambers, and I'm running for the US Senate to be one of the votes needed to codify a woman's right to choose as the law of the land.
Yeah, his ads are incredibly raw. And also, by the way, 100% accurate. Some people who are on the right side of this issue might not like seeing that. And I get it. The reality that we are entering into as a country can be triggering, can be incredibly upsetting. Many of the people who will complain about this ad, though, on the other side, don't want to see it and don't want you to see it because they are perfectly fine with what you saw in that video happening. In the abstract, they don't want it to be focused on. They'd prefer that you not think about it, but they're perfectly fine with that happening. They know that it's inevitable. They are pushing for the world depicted in that video.
No, they think also similar to the story of the 10-year-old who was raped and had to seek an abortion in a neighboring state, whose story they disbelieved and will continue to disbelieve. That will be common, as well as what we saw in that video will be common. You guys, this is not ancient history. You know, I just watched the HBO doc The Janes on HBO, there we go, which was about women before the right, before Roe v. Wade was passed, getting their abortions from the mafia, random shady characters they didn't know, and going to a weird hotel room, being treated really, really brusquely, and then being left with another woman or whomever else to bleed out effectively and being left alone. And then they had to then call 911. That was the protocol. It was like, we'll do the abortion, you're gonna bleed, then you're gonna call 911. Like, that's what will happen. That was in this like late 60s.
Yeah.
And this, obviously, the Janes really took it up. I mean, they were like a clandestine abortion clinic that were run by women and were incredibly dope and did heroic work. But like, it's not, the right is gonna look at that and be like, that never happens. No, it does happen all the time.
Yeah. Yeah, 100%. Yeah. And they're perfectly happy, fine with that. I like, by the way, that Gary Chambers pointed out the possibility for blackmail. Yeah, there's the immediate health consequence, there's the added cost and everything. And then also, you're doing something that they've decided is gonna be illegal. And so think about the exploitation that could come about as a result of that, that will come about. Like, we've talked about this sort of thing, what, hundreds of times through the course of this show and your show and the network and everything.
Yeah.
We were talking about it as a, don't let this happen because it'll be bad. Now we're talking about what is set to happen.
Yeah.
States are outlawing it as we speak. And I know some people will be like, no, but you're still kind of exaggerating. There's so many people in like the legacy media that are like, no, don't even, people are freaking out. But like eventually in a couple of years, it'll settle down and we'll all have agreed on 15 weeks as a ban or whatever, never mind that many states have already gone way beyond that. No. You do not understand if you're one of these people who are so disconnected, where the news that they're covering is, it is just a career, there's no human cost to it. They are racing past that. And I'm not speaking hypothetically.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.